Hey, welcome back to How to Purchase a Home in the Pacific Northwest During a Pandemic. I'm Cassandra Marks, licensed realtor with John L. Scott Real Estate in Oregon and Southwest Washington. Last week, we chatted a little bit about the home inspection and kind of got through that section of the contingencies. This week, we're gonna do a final review on contingencies and kind of get a status update of where we are in purchasing your new home. In previous videos, we have reviewed some of the typical contingencies that you'll see in a real estate transaction. And in this video, we're gonna go through the few leftover contingencies. So let's start chatting. The first contingency up is the earnest money. And we've already taken care of that because you turned in your earnest money to escrow in the first 2 to 3 days after the transaction got into mutual acceptance. So check that one off. Next up is the full loan application. And honestly, that one was completely taken care of before we even offered on the property because you were fully underwritten being buyer ready day one. So you don't even have to worry about that. It's all taken care of. Check. So one contingency that we haven't talked a lot about is the seller's property disclosures. And typically this is 8 to 10 page document here in Oregon and Washington where it's questionnaire style. It just asks questions of the seller of the history of the property. Like what type of water source, is it well, is it public, is it on septic, is it on sewer, are there any known water or fire damage to the house, has there been any sort of materials used in the construction of the home that have been a part of a lawsuit. Just kind of gives you a general idea of what is going on with the property. And as a buyer, you have 5 days to review the property disclosures and ask questions of the seller and, you know, either approve or disapprove of what you find on there. And honestly, the sellers have to be, you know, completely accurate to their knowledge and must disclose everything that they know about the property, because what could happen is you could learn something during this property disclosure statement as a buyer that, you know, might cause you to offer less money for the property because you didn't know it when you just looked at the property. Or, you know, it might cause you to walk away from the sale altogether because it's something you just don't want to be a part of. So we review the documents and then you decide whether you want to continue moving forward or if you want to terminate the transaction. I have a little story about the seller's property disclosures. So we recently purchased a property and after a few months we started doing renovations and we were pulling some drywall out of one of the rooms and we found that the inside of the wall was completely full of mold and that it was very, very wet. And what had happened was the windows had not been installed correctly, the flashing around them. So the water was actually leaking in between the window and the flashing and leaking down the wall. And after discussing with some of our neighbors that we love, come to find out they all knew about it too. So this was something that was not disclosed to us and actually ended up costing us about $6,000 because we ended up residing a portion of the house because the siding was so damaged that we couldn't keep it. So it was our choice. We didn't ask the sellers to help us because they knew. We just ended up stomaching the repair and moving along on our remodel. But you know, it's something that would have changed our mind on a price. I don't think we would have backed out, but we definitely would have offered them less money knowing that we would have had to put a larger repair into the side of the house. The next contingency is the lead-based paint contingency. And in Oregon and Washington, if you've got a house that's older than 1978, there is a contingency that allows you to do an inspection for lead-based paint. You can reserve the right to do it and you don't have to do it, but it's there and it's available for you. Another contingency that we've probably brought up in a previous video is the HOA document review. And so if your house happens to be in an HOA that you're purchasing, you know, you get 5 business days to look through all the documents and see, it's usually, you know, probably 80 to 100 pages worth of documents about what the HOA covers, what your responsibilities are as a homeowner. Something you want to be really knowledgeable about because each HOA is completely different. So you get 5 days to review and ask questions and then either continue to move on the transaction or terminate. The next contingency on the list is the home inspection, which we completely covered last week. We've done all of our inspections. We negotiated with the sellers and to where they're gonna be and where we agree to go. And we are moving along. And so check, that one's done. So we've covered the big ones, but in the state of Oregon, sometimes you'll see a few other contingencies, one of them being a siding contingency, just kind of depending upon what the siding of the house is. And the other one that's pretty common in Oregon is a wood burning stove insert contingency, because they have to be certified by the state in order for them to be legal to be in the property. As for Washington, some of the additional contingencies you can see in their state are buyer's evidence of funds, possibly a condo resale certificate, which is condos and sometimes townhomes, identification of utilities, and as well as a neighborhood review contingency. All right, guys. So I know that I threw so much information at you in this video, but honestly, there's a lot when it comes to buying and selling a home. And I know it seems super overwhelming. You got to track all these dates, but as a realtor, that's my job. And that's why who you work with absolutely matters, because you want them to put you in the forefront and make sure that you're getting all the information that you need in a timely fashion so that you can purchase your home. And that's why I have a tracking system. I use a spreadsheet and I send it back and forth in email to you and update it every couple days, just so you know kind of where our timelines are at, what information needs to be collected, and to make sure that you're okay to move along in your process. So we have only two contingencies left, and we're gonna talk about those next week. That is the financing contingency and your appraisal. And those are biggies, so get excited, because we're really, really close to closing on your new home. Well, it's that time. So if you've got any questions or comments or feedback about the video, please drop a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. Also, don't forget to like this video. We've got two left before you purchase your home. I'm so excited, oh my gosh. Like I said, that's my favorite day, is the day we close and hand over keys. We're almost there. Also, subscribe to my channel. There's a lot more coming, including possibly a day where I decide to hammer my finger on the farm. Other than that, I really appreciate you so much for stopping by. Thanks.